WICR. From the basement of La Penta, this is your host, The Rock Is on this Monday, February 27th, 2017, the last Monday of February. We have a lot to get to, a lot to talk about. We got some baseball, spring training's underway, some basketball, MAC tournament starting this week, and we'll touch upon some news regarding the locals, but we'll first get into baseball and spring training, and we'll first talk about the New York Mets. Now, we know that this Met team, it's ready to go. It has the pieces to win a championship. Some pieces are a little iffy, like catcher, like their bullpen. Probably going to be without Jerry's Familia for the first. My gut feeling says month of the season, it's probably going to be a 30-game suspension. Maybe more. Worst-case scenario, it's going to be over 30 games. Or maybe a whole season. But I think it's going to be 30 games when all is said and done. So you're going to be without the Mets are probably going to be without their closer for the first month of the season, and they need to find somebody to fill that void there. But also, the main component, now we all know the main component and the main piece for the Mets this year is their bullpen. Their starting pitching rotation. When you have Noah Syndergaard, Matt Harvey, Jacob deGrom, Steven Matz, and possibly Zach Wheeler, depending on how he does in spring training. But there's one question and one thing that remains the same, and that a lot of Met fans are worried and just kind of, I would say, a bit apprehensive about, is can this Met team, or can the Mets starting pitching, stay healthy throughout the course of the season? Yes, we all know guys are going to get tired, their arms are going to feel like they're falling off, they may need to skip a start or two here and there, I get it, but the question is, can this Mets starting pitching rotation stay healthy throughout the course of the season? Because if you remember, last year, the Mets lost 4/5 of their starting pitching rotation. They lost Matt Harvey, who had to have season-ending surgery, which he said he felt shoulder discomfort, but I think it was all mental and psychological. Maybe losing that game in the World Series, or losing Game 5 of the World Series to the Royals, where he couldn't finish the deal and couldn't retire the final few batters, maybe that left a psychological wound on him. I don't know. But that was then, this is now. And then not to mention, you have Jacob deGrom, both Jacob deGrom and Steven Matz having some elbow problems last year. Steven Matz with the bone chips in his elbow. And who knows, maybe that could be an ominous sign. Knock on wood, hopefully it's not the case there. And then lastly, Zach Wheeler, who missed not only last season but the season before, who underwent Tommy John surgery, had some setbacks here and there, and we don't know if he's going to be in the starting pitching rotation or come out of the bullpen. That's up to Terry Collins to decide, and let's see how he does during spring training. And then, of course, not the best of the rest. And I have to admit, this guy's work ethic and his passion, his competitiveness, is just off the charts. And as a Met fan, you gotta love the guy. Noah Syndergaard, a.k.a. Thor. And as you read the reports, over the offseason, he gained 17 pounds of muscle. So he's stronger, he's faster, he looks bigger, and he has more endurance, and he's more fit. Now, some factors that could play into that decision, or, you know, Syndergaard wanting to get strong is, hey, I saw what happened to my teammates last year. Maybe they weren't as fit as a ball player as an MLB player needs to be. I want to be that way. I don't want to get hurt. And it's also just that competitiveness and that desire and that will to win, or the will to want to win. And that's what Syndergaard has. And he even said openly that I want to be a Met for the rest of my career, and I want to win a World Series, and I want to be the best in this game. You got to tip your hat off to that guy, because that's a winner right there. And now, after discussing the starting pitching, the Mets obviously have some other holes to fill. Like I said earlier in the segment, bullpen's a little iffy. Don't know how long Familia is going to be suspended for. somebody's got to fill the void there, and then hopefully the relievers that they have can come through in the later innings when it matters the most. Another enigma or another question mark could possibly be the catching position with Travis d'Arnaud. Now we know Travis d'Arnaud has some has shown some glimpse of hope of the way he can, like I say it, he's shown some glimmers here and there in terms of like, hey, he can be the guy, he can be the everyday catcher, or he can be the catcher for the Mets for years to come. But you know, in years prior, you haven't seen it, though. The guy is an abysmal hitter, and not to mention, he's a terrible, just an absolutely terrible fielder. Because you saw in the World Series what the Royals did when they had a runner on first. They just ran, and just ran, and d'Arnaud, and it's not as if they, you know, they beat the throw. Because obviously they did, but it's just the throws were just so offline and so erratic. Yeah, honestly, it's like it was pretty much a gimme. Every time the Royals stole second, it was a gimme, or stole a base, it was a gimme. Because you know, in the professionals or in MLB, in the major leagues, if you're not a good hitter, if you're not good at the plate, and you're starting, you better be one hell of a fielder. Because granted, not every ball player is a five-tool player and can do it all. Some guys can hit home runs, but they can't hit for average. They're not a good fielder, or they're a good fielder, but they can't hit. You know, like there's something that got them there in the first place. And like I said, if you're not a good hitter, in d'Arnaud's situation, if you're not a good hitter, you better be one hell of a fielder. Because the Mets can't afford to have a player in their lineup that not only can't hit, but can't field. And also, it's catcher, so it's probably one of, if not the most important position defensively in baseball. You gotta call pitches, you gotta throw runners out, you gotta go with your gut instinct if a runner's gonna steal or not, and you gotta make the throws that matter the most. And you gotta, also, when the throw comes to you and a runner's about to score, you gotta hold on to that ball and make sure that you either keep it in front of you or field it cleanly. Because I'm thinking of old school baseball where you can just collide with the catcher, though, and try to disrupt play. But now MLB invented rules where it's like you can't do that. So the contact there in that regard is minimized. But, you know, like I said, catcher is an important position defensively in baseball. And then with the other holes, other question marks that the Mets have is, how's David Wright's status? Is he going to be healthy? We know he can't throw. He's been dealing with spinal stenosis for the last 2-3 years. He's not the player that he once was. Do you make that move to put him from third, or you move him from third base to first base? Because it just seems inevitable at this point. If he wants to play baseball, He's got to play first base. Give him a catcher's mitt. Give him a first baseman's mitt, and let him play first base. Because that's what happens with players later on in their careers. If they can't run, they can't throw as hard, or they can't throw, or they're not as fast as they once were, they just move them to first base because it's very, very minimal movement and not a lot of throwing. But that just seems inevitable at this point for David Wright. It's either that or maybe he should just retire. But we gotta see how it plays out. And then a lot of Met fans forget about this name, though. But this guy, you know, when he's on a tear, though, there's no stopping him. And that's Lucas Duda. Now, Duda missed pretty much all of last year with a back injury. He had a great 2015 season, and he's a streaky player. I'm not going to dispute that. He is a streaky player. He'll go on a streak where he'll hit like, let's say, 6 home runs in a week, and then he'll be ice cold, or he won't hit a home run for like 2 months. He's a very streaky player, but I think he's one of those players where it's like, if he's consistent and he can hit, let's say, 260, 270, give you 20, 25 home runs, drive in 80 to 90 RBIs, you know, that's a guy you want to keep on your team. And I think, and you just, as a Met fan, you just got to hope that he bounces back and that he doesn't have any injuries or any setbacks in spring training. Now, this Met team has all the components, all the pieces to be a World Series contender. There's no denying that. The window of opportunity is now for the Mets. And I will say this, though. If the Mets do not win a World Series within the next 5 years, this will be an utter disappointment. Back after this.